Let's try to make air more precise. At least a bit. Have you ever tried to force an air cylinder to other force? Well, me neither, but today is the day. Compressed air supplied to the right hole is used to force an air cylinder to move. And force is equal to pressure times the piston surface area. Area depends on piston diameter, which is constant for one air cylinder, and pressure, which depends on our supply. This particular one generates about 360 kilograms at 7 bar, which translates to 790 pounds for inch enthusiasts. At least that's true for pushing. For pulling, the force is lower. For the opposite, the area is lower due to the piston rod. The air goes in through these holes. Now this is an electronic pressure regulator, called also an ETV type regulator. It's got three sockets. The supply input, a G socket, minus blind, pressure output, and the exhaust. It's got also some buttons for advanced users and the electric cable socket. The cable's got four wires in it. Brown positive, blue ground, white input analog, and black pressure monitor output. Mine's designed for a quarter inch connectors. And a DPF for the exhaust. Now this is a solenoid valve, but I will use it just as a connector adapter, as it got the right threads to fit my fittings. So just ignore it while watching this video. Air pressure supply will go into the supply input, and on the output there will be an open pressure reductor with a blind output. It is equipped with a gauge to measure what happens on the output of the regulator. And a 24 volts power supply to energize the regulator. The connections are simple, nothing fancy here. And the air goes in here. And here is the main idea what will happen today. Let's do the electric part. Now the potentiometer circuit, which will create our 0 to 10 volt signal. I will try a 10K potentiometer with a soldered 14K resistor to one of its ends. The middle one is the output, and the last one will be the other end of the potentiometer. Actually, it would be smarter to test the 0 to 10 volts signal before connecting the regulator. I love welding scent, but not particular smoked electronic smell. And here we go. We have a nice DIY 0 to 10 volts signal generator. Let's connect the regulator now. With supplied air, it should work a bit better. And with Matty, even better. Here's the set pressure on the compressor unit. And boom, no smoke. If somebody came for the manual, you are welcome. By pressing the buttons, the output pressure behavior can be set. By default, it's 0% for zero signal and 90% for max signal. I added a voltmeter to check what happens on the input signal. And here we go. The output pressure is proportional to the input voltage, but the range is a bit lowish. Let's do some maths. It seems the resistance might be a bit too much, which leads to a low amperage. 10 milliamps should be still safe and much more robust. And here is the new potentiometer. With 10 times less resistance, I changed also the resistor to 1.4 kΩ. Another dry test. Perfect. And that's much better. That thing is quite responsive. Not 8 bar at full though. Wait, I have an idea. At 7.6 bar at max. I guess we lose the remaining 0.4 bars somewhere between the compressor output and the regulator input. The pressure adjustments seems to be fast and accurate. If I had 10 bar on the input, I guess it would be 10 bar at 10 volts. On my settings, we get about 1 bar per 1 volt. I think we are ready for the air cylinder. And it seems to work. I think we force the actuator to change its force without changing its piston diameter. And even quite precisely for a pneumatic one. The valve in it seems to adjust the pressure even when I apply force to the cylinder. I guess there is nothing more to prove, but there is still curiosity. And physics and maths help to cure curiosity. But there is one more thing, the monitor output. Mine has a 0 to 5 volt output, so there should be 0 volt at 0 pressure and about 3.5 at 7 bar. I guess it kind of works. What happens when, in an accident, we remove the air supply? The manual says to avoid that. The regulator wants to keep up with the input signal, but there is no air. There is nothing to regulate. To sum everything up, the device seems to be fine for forcing air cylinders to do something else they usually do in their size using electricity. It will work in other applications as well. It regulates, quite responsive and precise, the air pressure on its output. The pressure range is between zero and maximum supplied to the air input. I bought mine for max 10 bar, a quarter inch sockets, voltage input signals and 0 to 5 volt monitor output. But those are available also for other pressures, for other socket sizes, input signals types and monitoring signals. There are also more advanced settings, but I'm not going to dive into that. My application for this regulator will be a tailstock air cylinder in my CNC lathe I'm building right now. I want to be able to change the force it will be generating, between 0 and somewhere about 400 kilograms. I guess I'm fine with that. For those who would like to buy one, I leave a link in the description. If you find this stuff I'm showing here useful, feel free to subscribe, like and comment down below. If you made this far, thanks for watching.